Let's try writing some expressions from word descriptions, adding brackets where needed to make the meaning of the mathematics correct, but only where needed. Start with 5, add 6, and multiply the answer by 3. Okay, start with 5, then add 6. Now I want to multiply by 3, but if I just write times 3, then the convention for order of operations says that the times should happen first. I want the times to happen last, so I need to put the first bit I had in brackets. 5 plus 6 times by 3. Let's evaluate this expression. Brackets first. 5 plus 6 is 11. Now the times. 11 times 3 is 33. Pretty easy? We'll do a few of these to practice the skills. Notice the way I've set this out, by the way. I'm working vertically down the page. This is an important habit to set for later when the algebra gets a bit harder. Always work down the page. My equal signs are all lined up underneath each other. In fact, any time I have something that's the same as the line above, I leave it directly underneath where it was before. Even when I do the operations, you can see I've written the value directly underneath what it came from. This again is a helpful habit to get into for when the problems get a bit harder and you can't keep everything in your head. It helps you to see where you came from and to keep track of what you're doing and to find your mistakes quickly and easily. It also shows very clearly exactly what I did at each step. Start with 13, subtract 6, and divide the answer by 3. So, start with 13 and subtract 6. Now, if I say divide by 3, will that be what I want? No, that would mean 13 minus 6 divided by 3. I want to do the subtraction first, so I need brackets. 13 minus 6 divided by 3. Okay, now evaluate it. 13 minus 6 is 7, and 7 divided by 3 is 2 and 1/3. Notice again the setting out. Working down the page, equal signs line up, everything directly underneath where it was on the line above. Start with 6, multiply by 3, add 89, and multiply that answer by 5. Start with 6, multiply by 3. Add 89. Do I need brackets? No, because the convention says that the times is done before the add. Multiply by 5. Do I need brackets? Yes, because the convention says that otherwise the times would happen first, and I don't want that. Now evaluate. Brackets first, and inside the brackets, multiplication before addition. 6 times 3 is 18. 18 plus 89, that's 107. And 107 times 5 is 535. Could you do that without a calculator? Let's try some harder ones. Start with 18, divide by 6 and multiply by 4, subtract that answer from 36, and then add on 56. Okay, 18 divided by 6. Multiply by 4. Do I need brackets? No, because the convention says I do the divide and the times in order from left to right, which is exactly what I want. Now, be careful. Subtract the answer from 36. It's not just what I've got already, minus 36. I have to subtract this from 36. So put the 36 on the left and subtract the previous answer from it. Do I need brackets here? Actually, I don't. The divide and times will be done before the minus. And then add on 56. Do I need brackets? No, I don't, addition and subtraction are done in order from left to right. A bit trickier? To be honest, if I encountered this expression in a real problem, I probably would put brackets around that bit in the middle, just to make sure I didn't make a silly mistake later on. However, I did say that for this exercise, we were only going to put brackets where they were strictly necessary, so we'll leave them off for now. To evaluate, do the division and multiplication in order. 18 divided by 6 is 3, times 4 is 12. Now the subtraction and addition, in order. 36 minus 12 is 24, plus 56 is 80. Notice I'm still setting it out vertically, down the page. Equal signs are lined up, equal things are underneath each other. Get into this habit. Always work down the page. Subtract the product of 3 and 8 from the product of 9 and 7. Now, product means times, and be careful of that subtract from again. Subtract the product of 3 and 8 from the product of 9 and 7. No brackets needed here. The products happen first, before the subtract. 9 times 7 is 63, and 3 times 8 is 24. 63 minus 24 is 39. One more like this. Multiply 8 by 5, subtract 6, and then divide by 4. Multiply 8 by 5, subtract 6. No brackets needed, the times happens first. Divide by 4. I need brackets now because otherwise the divide would happen first. To evaluate, do the brackets first. Inside the brackets, do the times first. 8 times 5 is 40. Now 40 minus 6 is 34. Finally, 34 divided by 4 is 8.5. The same process works with variables too. Of course, we can't evaluate these, but we'll write the expressions anyway. The sum of 3a and 5. 3a plus 5. No brackets needed because the 3a means 3 times a, and the times happens before the plus. 10 less than the product of b and 5. Well, 10 less than the product means we have to subtract 10 from the product. And by convention, we write the product of b and 5 as 5b. You can write b times 5 if you like, but by convention, we normally write the 5 as a coefficient of the variable b. Again, no brackets are needed because the product is a multiplication, which happens before the subtraction. 8 times the sum of q and 17. 8 times the sum. So let's have the sum of q and 17, and we need 8 times that. We'll need brackets because we want the times, which would normally be first, to happen last. Notice I've written it without the actual times sign. I don't need to write it because multiplication is implied between the number 8 and the bracket. The square root of the sum of 4 and 2c, subtracted from p. Subtracted from p, so put the p minus in first. Now, what are we subtracting? The square root. The square root sign actually functions as its own kind of bracket. Just extend the line of the square root over the whole of what you need the square root of. In this case, the sum of 4 and 2c. No brackets needed inside the square root. 2 times c happens first, before the plus.